As early as I can remember, the dynamics of everything around me dictated the way I should act, who I was supposed to be, and what I was never to do. My family had an image to uphold within church and society. It was all in the name of walking the path that was expected, the common assembly line. It was important to be seen as being normal, exhibiting class, godliness, and decency. I became aware of my unique individuality from an early age, but I was always discouraged. I was a tad bit brash and brutally honest. I was told children ought to be seen and not heard, or at least only heard to be saying what was deemed to be okay and acceptable. Okay? Stay in line, little lady. And that I did throughout my schooling until the end of high school. I sniffed freedom, tasted it, and got so addicted. I scrapped the goody-two-shoes act and embraced who I knew myself to be. Freedom was bittersweet. Dropping out of college and becoming an unwed mother at the age of 20 was neither classy nor godly. One could only imagine the ridicule and gross stain and embarrassment I was said to have brought on myself and my family. I was afraid, but I was always unorthodox in my ways. I had to perfectly blend my taught morals, newfound freedom, and garnered wisdom through tough experiences to truly define my path. I was always instructed, "Be careful of what you say, Elisabeth." I'd say, "I'd rather use wisdom. And careful is no damn fun." As I matured, my personal conviction became to care less and less about what everyone else thought and more about doing my own thing and what was right. I knew that I got this. I was often underestimated because of my petite stature and my age at the time. In every new chapter of my adult life, I've been doubted. I tackled doubt, fell a few times, but always came out the other side triumphantly. I am determined to be unapologetically, authentically me. I write a Facebook blog, 5,000 strong, where I continue to ruffle feathers, annoy polite society, as I share lessons learned, wisdom gained, and encourage my readers to live an authentic life. Thank you.